Hi, in this video, we'll be looking at functions and relations. Specifically, we'll be focusing on relations, domain, and range. When it comes to domain and range, we need to ask ourselves two questions. The first question is, where can this function go? The second question is, where is this function allowed to exist? We're familiar with the ordered pairs already. In Cartesian plane, an ordered pair is expressed in this form, x, y. X is the first coordinate and it corresponds to the horizontal distance from zero. Y is the second coordinate and it represents the vertical distance from the origin. So that's ordered pairs, and a relation is a set of ordered pairs. So if you have multiple ordered pairs and you put them together, all together we call this a relation. So in this example, S is known to be a relation because it is a set of ordered pairs. We have four ordered pairs. They are 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6. So every relation determines two sets, the domain and the range. For domain, we're taking all the first coordinates of each of the ordered pairs. So in this case, I've color-coded them, so it's all the blue numbers. Okay, so the domain will be 1, 3, and 5. The reason why we only write 1 once is because we don't repeat ourselves. Okay, now for domain, we're talking about x values. So even if you have two or more values that are the same, we only count each value once. So the domain of this relation is 1, 3, and 5. What about the range? The range, we're talking about the second coordinates of each of the ordered pairs. And I used red to color code all the second coordinates in this relation. So the range of x is 1, 2, 4, or 6. It corresponds to all the second coordinates of the ordered pairs. So on the right-hand side, you can see a graph representing this relation. We have all the ordered pairs plotted on this graph. So the domain refers to all the x values. And since we have x value 1 and 3 and 5, so they are the domain for this relation. The range refers to the y values. Now, since the y values in our ordered pairs are 1, 2, 4, and 6, so the range of x is equal to these four values. Okay, so domain corresponds to all the x values, and range, we're talking about the y values. So when it comes to writing the rule for a relation, we do have a specific structure. So you would write your ordered pair first, and write your function, and then finally, you would write your x values and its domain. So this is x is an element of the curly bracket 1, 2, 3, 4. So that means x is an element in this given domain. And altogether, you would put everything in curly brackets to represent our relation. So in the first part, ordered pair, we are specifying what are the two variables. Okay, so we are exploring the relationship between x and y. So that's why our ordered pairs used these two variables. And since we use these two variables, our function needs to contain x and y also. Finally, we need to specify the domain for x. So now we know the function is y is equal to x plus 1. We also know x takes the value 1, 2, 3, and 4 as stated in the question. So let's find some ordered pairs we can plot on this graph. When x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1 plus 1, which is 2. So that's how we found our first ordered pair. If you do the same thing, you're subbing the x value into this function to find the corresponding y value, you can find three other points. Each x value should correspond to the given domain in the question. So once we have the four ordered pairs, we can start to plot these points on our graph. So as you can see on the right, I plot the points. So this is 1, 2. The second point is 2, 3, 3, 4, and 4, 5. They are all on the same line. And this line is defined by the function y is equal to x plus 1. Now, since this function has been restricted by the domain, that means our final function should look like this. So only we should only include this section of the graph, okay? Because when x takes on the value from 1 to 5, then y only takes on the value from 2 to 5. So that's why the domain is 1, 2, 3, and 4, and the range is 2, 3, 4, and 5. So remember, for a linear function, each x value in the domain corresponds to a y value in the range, okay? Because they appear as ordered pairs. So here is an example on page 176 in your textbook, example 4b. So when it comes to a circle, it's quite interesting because we have an implied domain, all right? Because a circle is restricted, it normally has an implied domain. So again, to represent this relation, we have the ordered pair. So x and y, these are the two variables we're dealing with here. Then we have our function, so that's in blue. X squared plus y squared equals 1, and the green parts states the domain. So x is an element of this given domain, where x is greater than or equal to negative 1 and less than or equal to positive 1. And we know in a circle, when there is no x minus h squared or y minus k squared, then we assume the center of the circle is 0, 0, which is the origin. So we can easily figure out the center of the circle is the origin. And what about the radius? Now, since the general formula for a circle is x squared plus y squared equals r squared, so r is the radius, and in this case, r is equal to 1, so that implies the radius is equal to 1. So now that we know the center of the circle is at the origin 0, 0, and the radius is equal to 1, so this implies the leftmost point on our circle graph will be 0 minus 1. Okay, so negative 1 is the minimum x value. The rightmost point on this graph is positive 1, which is 0 plus 1. So our domain here is x is greater than or equal to negative 1 and less than or equal to 1. The reason why it's greater than or equal to or less than or equal to is because these two points are the end points. Our graph stops here. It doesn't go any further. So when we have end points, we use square brackets, which also implies that it's greater than or equal to or less than or equal to. The circle centered at 0, 0, the radius is 1. So that means the minimum point on our graph is 0 minus 1, which is negative 1. The maximum y value, okay, is 0 plus 1, which is this point. So the minimum value on this graph is 0, negative 1, and the maximum y value on this graph is 0 and positive 1. So that means our range is from this point to this point. So we take the two y values, the range is from negative 1 to positive 1, okay? Again, since these two points are the end points, so we use square brackets and we use greater than or equal to and less than or equal to. Now let's look at how to plot graphs with domain on your CAS calculators. Knowing how to use CAS is very important in section exams. So in this next section, I'll be talking about how to use your CAS to plot graphs with domain. It is not difficult to plot graphs without domain. So if we want to plot a graph y is equal to 2x plus 3, it'll just be something that looks like this. Okay, it's a straight line, it's a linear graph, it's nice and simple, there's no restriction on the domain. However, in the question, it says the domain is from negative 4 to positive 1, so that means we need to restrict our domain. You need to first type in your equation, so in this case, typing 2 times x plus 3. Now, since the given domain is from negative 4 to 1, we need to have this given sign after our function. So this given sign is control and equal. So if you press control and then equal, you should find this sign here. So it's a vertical line. So insert this vertical line after your function. Once you have this line, we also call this given, you should type your domain after this vertical line. Now, since the domain is greater than or equal to negative 4 and less than or equal to 1, that means we're dealing with greater than or equal to and less than or equal to. So again, if you press control and equal, you can find these signs next to the given sign. Right, so it's once you have your domain input, you click enter, it will plot the graph for you. And in this case, the domain has been restricted. We're taking x values that are greater than or equal to 4 or less than or equal to 1. So what's the corresponding y value when x is equal to negative 4? And also what's the corresponding y value when x is equal to 1? Here we are intending to find the range. To find range, we need calculation. Okay, so in the previous window, we have our graph nicely plotted. So if you click Control and I for insert, and 1, okay, so Control I and 1, you can insert a new calculator. So that's 1.1 is our previous window. Now we are on a new window 1.2. So once you opened a new calculator window, you can press var, which is right above your nine key. So it'll show the function you just defined. So since our function has been nicely defined as f1 of x, to find the corresponding y value, in other words, the range, we need to plug in the two x values for the domain, okay? We know the minimum value for x is negative 4, and the maximum value for x is positive 1. So if you plug in the two x values, our domain, negative 4 and positive 1, it'll give you two y values, which happen to be our range. So the range in this case is y is greater than or equal to negative 5 and less than or equal to positive 5. So here, since the domain was restricted and we used less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, so for the range, we also need to use the same sign here because they are the endpoints. Hope you find this video helpful and hope to see you in the next video. Bye!